Michael is here from Montreal. She's best known as one of Quebec's Dragon's Den dragons. To me, she doesn't act like a dragon. She is caring, she is passionate, she's intelligent, but she is a five seasons on Dragon's Den. And the reason they had her do that is because she's a businesswoman who's built her own business, an immigrant to Canada. She's gonna tell you a bit of the story, but also an investor. And so wearing that investor cap and her philosophy, that's what we wanna learn and hear from her today. Now, Danielle's main business is medical cosmetics, and so we'll hear a little bit about that. It's very, very successful. But as an investor, a successful investor and business person, she wants to exemplify being the most caring and humanistic investor and also a citizen. So please welcome to the podium, Danielle Hinkle.
Is everything about what I had to go through, what I learned through tough times, but happy times too. Now, when I arrived here, I worked a lot and built a company that has become a group today. My four children are with me in the company, so it is not a family company, it is a family within the company. I was chosen in 2012 as the first female dragon on this incredible journey that was the Dragon's Den. Nobody wanted to be on that board, and especially in Quebec, as you know, it's very difficult to talk about success and money. And I had not the profile of the strong, very corporate woman. I am very human in everything I do. I like it this way. And people that are not happy with it don't have to be by myself. So they asked me if I was ready to be the strong woman character that they need on the show, and I said, then you have to find somebody else. I decided to jump into the adventure because of everything I just told you. I remember when I write. I remember what it took me to grow. I remember when I went to a bank and asked for money and nobody wanted to lend me money. I remember not having family that had enough money for what we so-called love money. I remember not knowing where to start or who to speak with or who to speak to. I remember all that, and I decided at my level, whatever level is that, I will try to make a difference. And I have dedicated my life and what's left, and I will continue to promote women and education in entrepreneurship. I believe that we need to teach entrepreneurial skills at school. I believe that we need to remind mothers and fathers at home to speak to their son and to their daughters in a different way, which the gender equality or equity or parity should start there. I shouldn't tell my son that he could be an astronaut or a technician or a pilot, and my daughter that she could be just a nurse or an educator. Why is that? So this needs to change, and the change starts at home. Second, talking about should we invest or VC in female-led companies, really? Should I tell you today why we should do that? Haven't we passed that? Thank you for your question, sir, before. Because no, it is not easy, and no, we don't have enough VCs, female, that are involved into investing into other women-led companies. No, we don't. And there are different reasons why we do not. I think nobody has the truth into that. I think it is new also for women. It is a world that it's still thought that it's only men that are involved into lending or into VCs, men-led companies. I believe that the real reasons is because women need to have more models. We need models. You said, the gentleman before said that we have videos to show that women are successful. That's not enough. What is enough is on the field. It's to be part of understanding why women do business differently. Because we do. We do. Is it wrong? Is it right? It's neither or. It is just different. It is a different way of doing business. Are we better? Are we less interesting? No, we're just complementary. I think that companies, and it has been proven, that do have women on the board or women that lead major companies are in better shape. Do we have to prove more? I don't think so. So, I believe that today, what I wanted to share is, since I decided to be on the Dragon documentary, Dragon, thank you, Dan. Surprisingly, there are stats that came out last year. So after 5 years, we are capable. I'm on the board of the Foundation of Entrepreneurship, Quebec Entrepreneurship. So we do statistics to see if there is an evolution of more women that are interested of starting their own businesses or taking on a business like their father's or mother's business. And it surprised me because this TV show has done a great deal of empowering women. An example. 5 years ago, or 6 years ago, the percentage of women that were willing to be involved into their own business or start their own business was between 9 to 10, 11%. Last year, 35%. Now, are these women going on big companies or companies that are capitalized properly? No. Why? Same story. Difficult to raise funds. Very difficult to raise funds. Because maybe the business that they choose are not the one that we might be interested in. So what I would like to say is I have invested in women's business led by women, but I also have invested in young men, in technologies, in solar, because I believe that we should not look into gender. We should look into potential. Funny enough, I read something that women are judged mainly by their performance, and men are judged by their potential into a company. So if I could, I do have a voice today that I want to use to just reflect on the way we invest, with whom we invest, why we invest in different industries and categories. I know tech is very important. I know AI is very important. But I'd like to just say that all these technologies, even though they're very important, we need humans. We need humanity. We need to humanize companies. We need to look at the person that needs to be carried out and be pushed to grow. And women do need your attention. And I think that other women, the one in this room, for example, and men and gentlemen in this room, you should come together and see what can be done, how it can be done, which trend things can change. And I believe that it's into the action that things will change, and certainly not just around meetings and stats or statistics or reports. I think it's every day we should be doing one thing for someone out there that needs our attention, our help, and certainly knowing that we're making a difference, especially in this beautiful country that is Canada. So thank you very much, and I wish you the very best of it.
Two colors, blue is for men and beige, just kidding.